Today, we're going to review... another small printer. You know what? I'm going to review something bigger this time. Give me a second. Now, we're going to review the CR-10 Smart from Creality. My name is Bashar, and this is Stock 3D Printing. Okay, let's see what's inside the box. I already opened it. I don't see anything inside. Now, before I continue to talk about the printer and do the unboxing, just something to clarify. I pay for the price for the printer. I didn't get any discount or any promotion or anything from Creality. Yes, I pay the full price. I buy it from their website. Was not fun. Was taking them too much time to ship it to me. I think because it was like one of the first order come out. I really recommend it all the time, buy the printer from Amazon. Maybe for later we talk about it, but I think this is the star G code. I think this is similar what come with the CR6. I think that was my second printer. Ooh, I love foam, really organized. Let's start with those. Two of them. Okay, this is building tube and the spool holder. Okay, the burger flipper and filament sample. And what is this? You know, let me take all this. Again, the spool holder screw. What is this? Wait. I think that's screen. Is there anything else? I think that everything. Whew. Now the challenge here with all my flashlight is take. This is separate. Okay. Look at this. That's very nice. Oh, I already have the binding tool, but that one come up first was like a spare one. Okay, let's put this in the side to take out the bed. Okay, let's remove more foam. More. That really big printer. By the way, the printer has come with a 300 by 300, 400. I'm not mistaken. Awesome. And this is the bed. Look cool. Okay, I'll put it aside to remove the box. I think that everything. Let's take the box. Oops. See, I have a lot of flashlight. Now, this is the printer, what's come from it so far. I'm very sure, I think. Yeah, same the CR6. You will get all other tools, the memory card, SD. I love that. Cutter is very small. This stuff, extra nozzle, cleaner, not bad. And now, let's assemble it. Assemble. I've been printing for spend like 3 weeks printing, or you print those stuff. you can see it in front of you, and we're going to talk about it later. Now, let's talk first about the assemble. The assemble was simple, easy, straightforward. There is three bullet screw here and two screw here. But I have one issue. The belt was wobbly, and I took me some time to fix it. I have no access from this side. I took all these glass and the sink here and tied it, which is good to go. And after that, I start print. Now, usually when I print, I like to start with the stuff being pre-sliced with the printer, which is in the memory card, which is all these stuff I try, and there's some other stuff doesn't go well. Now, the first one you notice, or the first one I start printed is the Lucky Cat, and unfortunately I have no luck with this one, because it was one to stick at all. Whatever I did, clean the bed, auto bed leveling, and do the leveling multiple times, doesn't want to stick. Start in the here, like in this side, once hit this, start moving, and this is what the max thing I can do it without glue. Now I put glue in it a little bit, and after that stick, and I come with this beautiful Lucky Cat, and I really like it. Now after that I print the Lucky Cat, and I start notice there's a small string here. I was not worried too much about it, but it's get really bad here with this Pokemon that I don't know what's called, but it's like from Pokemon, and it's really bad. Look at that. That's not good. But you know what? In the end, it's very smooth, and the skin, and there's nothing wrong with it except those string here. You can see them. And I print the piggy bank, and which come nice. You can see there's some lab, but beautiful. And the cup here was some, I think, if I'm not mistaken, because usually I print them like in different days, and the weather was so hot, I was... don't like to keep my printers all on. This was with the support, but again, you can see the stringing here. And the very bad one, it's that dinosaur. I remember this with the CR-6 was really beautiful, but not with the CR-10. I don't know why this happened. That's supposed to be from Creality. There's nothing I can change. I just print, just click print, should be print good. But Creality doesn't do it good this time. And it's not only me. I see a lot of people post their test filament. Sorry, the test files. And they have the same issue. I end up printing this, I don't know, that stool, I believe. Or I don't know, what is it? I was run out from the filament. And the sensor, the run out sensor stopped the print. Where it have no filament. And you can see the line. I don't know if you can see it. I will zoom it later on a different camera. And I changed that with a different filament, but also that another spool was almost gonna gone, and I said, I don't want a spool stool. I said, let's stop it. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I was went to camp, and I was not sure to leave a new printer in test run to be printing when I'm away for like 3-4 days. I stopped it, and I said, I really didn't need it. But it's come out nice, and we test the runout sensor filament, which is work great. I decide after that to download the Cura, or to slice some file, and they don't have the profile in Cura, but in the memory card they have, Creality have their own slicer, and I'm not big fan of the idea of each company have their own slicer, because I love to have the profile in Cura or Prusa, whatever, those main slicer, and make it easy for you, because when you have multiple printer, it's not bad, it's really good. I download it in the end, and let me test it, whatever being sent with the printer. I want to test everything. And they have the profile for the CR-10 Smart. And it's come out. Now, I start with something simple. And I start with this Octopus, the Flexi one. Or not, the Flex. And come out beautiful. And again, still I'm using glue. Now, I push the limit a little bit high. And I scale this guy. If not mistake, 250 or 300, I think 250. This is a beautiful Mandalorian. I come out very beautiful. I have nothing wrong with it. It's beautiful, all these details and color. By the way, this is a Erwin Rainbow filament. I really like their filament in general. You know it, guys. If you've been subscribed, you know me now. I like this brand a lot. After that, I try to print multiple stuff, and this is, I think, six or five. I print them together. Those like sunglasses clip or holder for the cars, for your car, and come out very nice. I have no problem with it. Now, I try to, and I print this beautiful design from Clock Spring. This is the, like a phone stand, and you can see it's nice. Now, this is print like this. Look, just show you quickly. This print like this. Now, there was one problem. This guy should be connected with this side with this side, and to hold the phone. Unfortunately, that failed. But still, the whole stand, the hard part, like those spring and all these, and the screw here, they're all work great. Like, have no problem. But I don't know why that happened for that piece, but still I'm gonna use it. And I print another thing from Clock Spring here. My daughter likes them all the time, asks me to print them more because she gave it to her friend and she used it and come out beautiful. Now I try not change the filament. I change with the BTG. Was not the best or clean BTG. This is like, I think, hot hanger for the bathrooms. I print them. Was not bad, but you need some change or tweaking around, but generally it's good. It's can print PTG. Now the real test was to test with the Flixie, with the TPU, and I print TPU has come out nice. There's a small things you can maybe need to be adjust or change, and will I get more or better result in TPU. But it's the first time from the default profile. It's come out beautiful. I just changed the material profile in the slicer, Creality slicer, and come out very nice. The printer have something called Smart. What is mean Smart? Smart is this printer have built in the Creality Wi-Fi box, if I'm not mistaken the name. That means allow you to print remotely. That means if you download their Creality Cloud or something, that app will allow you to print through the internet, like through the cloud. That means you can send it remotely from your phone. I tried this. That feature was simple. You just scan this barcode, you connect it with your Wi-Fi, and take like 5-10 minutes, and you can see your printer remotely. And I print this beautiful cube and come out very beautiful. Now, in the time when you print, you can see the progress from the printer, which layer you are in. Once it's finished, it send you a notification, say done. It's nice features. Now, but at the same time, it's limited because you cannot use it in, like, you need to have both the Creality app to access to your printer. You can't do the third part app, such as like the Octoprint. Doesn't work with this printer. There is no Octoprint with this one, except if you change some stuff. Now, this is what I print with the printer. In general, everything went very well with the printer. Small things, maybe I did something mistake or this and that, but in general, it's good. And also, I do on-demand printer. Some people reach me to help them to print some stuff, and I print like 5 or 6 things in this printer, and come out very nice. But the problem, I cannot share it with you because I want to share people design. Now, in this printer, there some stuff I like, and there's some stuff I don't like. Let's start with the stuff I like. Now, the printer have everything you need. You have the auto bit leveling. You have the ability to print remotely, the Smart. You have the touch screen. You have the light here. You have runout sensor. You have the tension belt. It's really heavy. It's very solid printer. As a design, beautiful. All these features. Also, the spool holder here. It's like spinning. When the printer pull this, the filament will be very smooth to pull the filament. The spool will not stuck or make a sound. Silent motherboard and all these stuff. All these stuff, nice. But there's only one problem I find in this printer. And I don't know if that printer is that like something in Creality in general, or I have bad luck with Creality. This is my third printer with Creality, and all the time I have issue from manufacturers. For example, this printer was wobbly. My bed glass doesn't stick. Now, in the Facebook group, people, they receive it, have no problem. Their bed stick, whatever they print, they still don't need to use the glue. And I don't know if that manufacturer issue or quality control issue with Creality, but I have no luck with it. And I hope that that's what I ordered from Creality website. Now, in the beginning of the video, when I did the opening of the box and opened the box, I mentioned don't buy it from Creality because it takes too much time to deliver and all these stuff. And still I'm in the same point. Do not buy it from Creality, buy it from Amazon. In case you buy one and have some manufacturer issue, you can send it back to Amazon and you get your refund, or you can send it back, do the refund, buy a different printer. Hopefully it should be better. And it's not only I'm the only one who faced the problem. I have a small group in Facebook for the Smart 10. And I see a lot of people have issue with the printer, like bed leveling doesn't work, the motherboard doesn't work, some small things doesn't work, and even some of the people reach Creality and ask for full refund because they have a lot of issue with the printer. But for me in general, I have no issue except that wobbly bed, and otherwise this will be considered good printer. Now, other people really love it in the group, and there's a lot of people happy and they're printing amazing stuff. Now, this is the things maybe I don't like is the quality of, as I say. The other things, I have no issue with it, but you need to know about it. This printer doesn't gonna work with Octoprint. If you need to do that, you need to change something in the wiring, and I think you need to display the Creality Wi-Fi box is because it's built with the printer. And I really don't recommend it that. If you want an Octoprint, don't buy this printer. Let's make it simple and easy there. Now, if there's anything else bother me, the other things is bother me is that switch on. It doesn't off. The printer is here. And if I need to turn it off, I need to turn it from the back. I'm missing a different way. I really don't know. The other thing I don't like is the runout sensor and the extruder here. There is a space here. It used to be like a small piece you printed with the CR6 to guide the filament. Now, they have something similar, but it doesn't fit the CR10. I'm very sure it's for CR6. Because it's similar to the print that it used to be like from community come with a design to help the guiding for the filament. That's the only things maybe doesn't make you buy this printer if those things I say it is important. The last thing you need to remember is the printer doesn't support any web camera. I tested with like random webcam doesn't work. I think you need to have the Creality one, and unfortunately I don't have one. I don't test it. This is another thing you need to keep it in your mind if you want to have like an time lapse or something. Unfortunately, this printer do not support any webcam except the Creality webcam. Those the stuff I find out I don't like with the printer. Now, did I consider this printer for somebody new to the 3D printing? Yes, but for one condition, please buy it from Amazon. In case it's come out bad, you can refund it and get your money back. To be honest, also for support for Creality, I have not much luck with them all the time. They take too much time to reply. That's why I'm saying buy it from Amazon to keep you in the safe side. For farms and you have multiple printer and you need to do it, if you're gonna run them separate, yes, will be okay, good. But if you're gonna use Octoprint or stuff like this, I don't recommend it for you. Second printer, yes, for sure, is a big, is have all these auto bit leveling and all these amazing stuff. In the end, my review for this printer as a CR10 Smart. I try much I can to don't compare it with other printer. And in general, the printer is promising. It have a lot of things and build very well as a design, as a look, and everything look nice. And I believe if you have no issue when you receive the printer, you're gonna have amazing printer. That my review today for the CR10 Smart. If you agree with my review or you have a different opinion, I would love to read it in the comment below. Leave it below. I love to read it. And if you like my review, please don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and turn on notification. And as usual, I say it, please keep printing.